Get ready to make a match. It's match game. Meet today's panel. Andy Kindler, Debra DiGiovanni, Nile Seguin, Deanne Smith, Lainey Louie, and Seán Cullen. It's the game where we fill in the blanks with cash. It's match game. Welcome to Match Game. I'm your host, Darrin Rose. Let's say hi to our panel.
Hello, Darrin.
Hello, friends. Seán, how you doing, man?
I'm great, except I'm struggling with weight loss.
We were talking about this before. You having a little...
I've gone through a lot of different types of diet. There's the anchor and chain diet, where I attach a bunch of food to an anchor chain, row out into the ocean, throw the anchor in, and eat as much as I can of the food before it disappears into the ocean. And I often cling to it as far as I can go until I get the bends. Then I come back and go into a hyperbaric chamber.
Right.
But
it's
I've got a
tough
great
diet.
Yeah, well, I've got one I've worked on is the angry companion diet, which I'm on right now, where I have a giant, frightening Serbian man who lives in my house.
Gotta go, sir.
And he comes with me, and any time I want to eat something, he slaps it out of my hand and punches me in the face. But I play tricks on him. I, like, put a pie, and then I put a small explosive in it. So when he slaps it, it explodes, and shards of pecan go into his face.
Right, right. It's an adversarial relationship you have with your
anger. He takes it in stride.
That's nice, nice. But the diet is overall a success.
Yeah, I've lost 3 pounds.
Already.
It's only been 3 months.
And with that, let's meet our contestants. Let's welcome our first contestant. She's a teacher and a voiceover artist for cartoons and voice message systems. Ooh. Please welcome Paula Davis, everyone. Paula, how are you?
Yeah, nice to meet you.
And let's welcome our second contestant, who's a professional drummer who also plays in a competitive bowling league. Oh. Let's welcome Tim Van de Ven.
Yeah.
Tim,
how are you?
Good, good. We're all here. We're all friends. Let's play match game.
Yes.
All right, guys, let me explain what we do in the first round. Fill in the blanks, all right? The goal is to match as many of your responses to those of our panelists as you can. Every correct match is worth 50 points. Whoever has the most points at the end of the first three rounds wins. And then your points become dollars. And then you go on to play our Super Match and Star Wheel round.
Yes!
All right? Deb loves it. Here we go. Paula, you won the coin toss backstage. So, you have a choice to make. Would you like question A or question B?
I'm going to go with question A.
Question A. Solid choice. Mrs. Einstein said to her husband, "All right, Albert, now that you figured out the origin of the universe, maybe you could do something about your blank." Mrs. Einstein said to her husband, "All right, Albert, now that you figured out the origin of the universe, maybe you could do something about your blank." Yep. Oh, Andy, you ready?
I know this one.
Get a lot of knowledge of science. Bring to bear here.
Yes.
All right, here we go. Lainey's done. Paula, let me ask you this. You don't need any knowledge of science. Mrs. Einstein said to her husband, "All right, Albert, now that you figured out the origin of the universe, maybe you could do something about your..."
Bedside manner.
Your bedside manner for delivering all the bad news to, like, Newtonian physicists, perhaps. Andy,
well,
what
I was
have we
going
got
to
for Paula here? Yeah, no, yeah, go ahead.
Okay, I can't hear anything, though. I was going to say difficulty coming up with a unified field theory. That's what I was going to say.
Right? Yeah, which is difficult.
And also something about Higgs boson. Who's with me? But instead, I said hair.
Right. Yeah. The guy had some hair problems. Deb.
I know for a fact that Einstein was a tiger in the sack. I know that for a fact. Don't ask how I know. But I said hair.
Hair.
Because, come on.
Of course.
Come on, guys. Yeah. Let's get real.
And a man sporting a wily mane of his own.
I also know that Einstein was a tiger in the sack. Don't ask me how. And I recognize the irony of this answer.
She was wrong. She was wrong.
Deanne.
Well, I really wanted to say that Einstein should do something about his black hole. Burp, burp.
Keep it clean.
But instead, I said hair.
Yay.
Hair. With a little drawing.
Yeah.
I liked it.
Let's see the drawing.
Lainey.
I didn't think about his hair at all. I just kept thinking of his facial hair. I just said beard.
Oh. Beard.
Where's my cat, Mr. Schrodinger?
Yes!
TVs are turning off right now.
High quality physics jokes.
There's a lot of things you could talk about, like the unified field theory, like why does quantum physics not reconcile itself with relativity?
Right.
Anyway.
Well.
Now I'm learning something.
Thank you. This is the quantum foam. But ladies and gentlemen, I said BO, which people really don't.
Nobody talks about Einstein's BO.
Yes.
Although that didn't work out.
That is probably true.
No, I thought of hair like as soon as you walked away from me. So.
Right, slightly too late.
Too late!
All right, Tim, let's see what we can do for you here. Hipster Hank said, I tried that new natural bread that's made from trees. It's terrible. Every slice has blank in it.
That sounds awful.
Yeah, it does sound awful. Hipster Hank said, I tried that new natural bread that's made from trees. It's terrible. Every slice has blank in it. Now, just because we've moved on to trees, I don't want the physics jokes to stop.
Yeah. Pie, right? Is that 3.14?
We'll string you along with that theory.
Oh, yeah.
Easy, Newton.
Well,
are you trying to think of a physics joke?
I'm just trying to figure out about hipsters and trees, but I've done the best I can.
Yeah, hipsters and trees. Yeah.
Just in the ether right now, these kind of jokes.
Tim, Hipster Hank said, I tried that new natural bread that's made from trees. It's terrible. Every slice has blank in it.
Bark.
Bark. Of course, bark. Very logical. Let's see if we can find him a match, Andy.
I'm a genius. Let's just agree to that right now.
Totally. Yes.
Why am I yelling? Am I mic'd? Genius is yell. I went with, I'm going to make it more dramatic than it should be.
Bark. With arrows pointing at your answer.
Yeah, I figured I'd go
to indicate you didn't mean the blank portion of the card. You meant where the answer is written. Deb.
I truly don't remember what I wrote down. Because we were talking about science.
Yeah.
And then parts of my brain were like,
you were dropping pie.
What did I write? Let's find out.
Shoot.
Oh, I said acorn. Ooh. Hey, that's acorn. Just one.
It has one acorn. Every slice has acorn in it.
Skimpy bread.
Has a corn in it.
Every bite has an acorn.
An acorn.
Nile?
I was going to say something hilarious, but instead I went with bark.
I like that choice. You got a couple matches for Tim, Deanne.
I almost said bark, and instead I said squirrels.
Squirrels.
That can be
feisty bread.
She took it to her own place.
Chase it.
All right, Lainey.
I don't know.
I said leaves.
Leaves.
Hipsters. What hipsters do at parties.
They leave.
Smoke.
Leaves. Kids love that.
Wow, you're really trying to draw a difficult parallel.
No, I guess not.
Do you know any physics jokes?
I'm the dumb one over here.
No, you're not.
I'm the dumb
ditz. You have a different kind of intelligence.
I'm the dumb gossip ditz. That's all I know.
Well, I'm going to say something mean. I don't know.
Come on, Cullen. Time is relative.
Shut up, Rambo. I don't know. I said leaves as well.
Leaves as well. All right, we got a couple matches. Tim's got 100 balls at zero. We're right back with more match games. Let's get to know our contestants a little better. Paula, you are a voice artist. What's the secret to a good answering machine message?
Well, Darrin, we'll answer your question in priority sequence.
Wow. I believe you. That was good.
It's like I'm talking to a machine.
Really?
Wow, so when people phone you and you don't want to talk to them, they have no idea they've reached you.
That's right.
That's great. Tim, you're a drummer and a bowler. Mm-hmm. Are your drumming skills coming in handy with bowling?
A little bit. It's mainly fear that I use in both disciplines.
Fear?
Yes.
To motivate yourself or to intimidate your opponents?
A little bit of both.
Really?
Yes.
All right. I'm not sure exactly how that works.
I'm not sure either.
I like that. All right, you're ahead, Tim.
Okay.
And Paula, you're behind.
What?
Yeah, well, this is the reality of where we are right now. But you have a chance here. you're going to go first, so you can decide between question A or B.
I'm going to go B this time.
B, I like it.
Oh, no.
Sensuous Sally said, my new perfume makes me irresistible to drunk men. That's because it smells just like blank. Sensuous Sally said, my new perfume makes me irresistible to drunk men. That's because it smells just like blank.
I say
That's not a good one.
Yeah, you're gonna come up with your own answer.
I got it.
Yeah. See you.
Cheater.
Oh, everybody's almost done.
I came up with my own. I did, Mom.
Out of the S.
All right, here we go. Paula. Sensuous Sally said, my new perfume makes me irresistible to drunk men. That's because it smells just like...
whiskey.
Just like whiskey. Sure. Reasonable. Whiskey. Candy. Yeah.
I have a call back to your earlier thing about a hyperbaric chamber. I have a hyperbolic chamber. The greatest chamber I've ever been in. But seriously, let's get back to the game. Seriously. I went with rum.
Rum. Hello, ladies.
That's not the
answer. Deb.
I don't remember what I wrote. No, I do. My answer is not, I don't, it makes sense at all.
It's good.
Does it make sense?
It totally works.
I said you smell like a drunk woman, which is
irresistible to a drunk man.
I would assume so.
Yeah, she's got poor judgment right now. Let's do this.
Yes.
Nile.
In the neighborhood of that, I should have gone with whiskey, I'm sorry, but I went with low standards.
Yeah.
Deanne.
It smells like freedom.
Irresistible to drunk men, I wanted to say a father's love, but instead...
Father what?
Love. What does it smell like, Deanne? What does it smell like?
So that's where I got caught.
Yeah, it smells like guilt.
Aqua velva.
So instead, and awesome. I'm really sorry about this, Paula, instead I said, whiskey!
Yeah!
All right, score.
Lady.
And she gets the point.
Oh, sweetness. That was me.
Vodka, no dice, Sean.
All right, why do you have to buy a perfume to smell like whiskey? Pour whiskey on yourself.
Right.
That's my option, and it's cheaper. But it's cheaper. Said chicken wings, because you're going to want a snack.
You are going to want a snack.
Suicide.
Why the drunk people like
chicken? Tim, let me ask you this. Bob said, my buddy Steve is really dumb. He studied all night for a blank test. Bob said, my buddy Steve is really dumb. He studied all night for a blank test.
I got it. Oh, I got it this time. Forget about the other thing.
Our questions all written. Our questions are getting written.
I think everybody's here.
The questions, the answers.
Andy and Deb, when you're ready.
I'm
we're ready.
It's Debra.
Let's see this.
All right.
I was answering
Andy,
some now.
Bob said, my buddy Steve is really dumb. He studied all night for a blank test.
A blood test.
A blood test, of course. Oh. Anyone want to help you?
That would have been a good answer.
Useless. Andy.
Well, I'm more of a, what's it called when you've, I don't know what I'm saying, but I'm like a delinquent.
Idiot,
I'm a delinquent. I went with this instead.
A drug test.
Yeah. I think of drugs.
There you go.
Drug test. Am I right? I like how you're still you in print.
Yeah. Always tagging.
Deb.
Nice. I had two answers. I might have gone with the wrong one. Neither one matched Tim. But I said hearing test.
A hearing test.
How can you study for that? Just listening?
Yeah. It's crazy, in other words.
It's a crazy idea.
I'm so sorry. I went a little Olympic with it. I went urine test.
Right.
I'm embarrassed that I'm the first one to introduce this, but I said STD.
Low brow.
Jokes
about physics. Deanne. All right, Deanne? Lainey. Blood test.
Whoa!
There you go.
I'm getting
I jumped on the urine bandwagon.
Who wouldn't?
You can't get him off that bandwagon.
All right, that's Tim with 150, Paula with 50. But anything can happen when we're back with the excitement of the matchup round. It's 150 for Tim and 50 for Paula, but anything can happen in the matchup round.
Yay.
Because you guys can build up your score by fast matching with a celebrity partner of your choice against the clock. Oh. Paula, you're trailing right now, so you will go first. Who will your partner be?
I'm going to go with Deanne.
Deanne, quality choice.
Yes.
Yes.
Here's what we're going to do. We're going to show you a series of phrases on the panel in front of you. You choose your best response to each phrase. Every time Deanne chooses the same thing, you get 50 points. We'll do that as many times as we can in 45 seconds. Sound good? All right, I think that means yes. Let's get 45 seconds on the clock, please. And if you're ready, let's go. Cut the cord, phone cord.
Cut the cord.
No match. Metal detector, lie detector.
Lie detector.
No match.
Oh.
Coffee maker, star maker.
Coffee maker.
Match. Flat as a pancake, buckwheat pancake.
Flat as a pancake.
Match. Mother Earth, down to earth.
Mother Earth.
No match.
Ooh.
On the fence, picket fence.
On the fence.
No match.
What the?
Homegrown, organically grown.
Homegrown.
Match. Balance sheet, short sheet.
Balance sheet.
Match. Chemical peel, banana peel.
Banana peel.
Match.
Mm.
Lip service, customer service.
Lip service.
No match.
Come on.
Oh, and that's it. You get 300 points. Well done. Tim, who will your partner be?
I'm going to go with Andy.
Yes!
Andy.
Yeah!
Here we go. Let's get 45 seconds on the clock, please. The score to beat is 300. Let's go. Tiger Woods, Elijah Woods.
Tiger Woods.
Match. Tough break. Give me a break.
Give me a break.
Match. Cable car, racing car.
Cable car.
No match. Snake bite, frostbite.
Snake bite.
No match. Life is a highway, information highway.
Information highway.
Match.
One more.
Sunlight, highlight.
Sunlight.
Match. Yes! And we got a winner. Tim is ready to play our super match.
Yeah.
We surveyed 100 people across the country and got their best response to this clue. Wild blank. Now, Tim, if you guess the most popular answer in our survey, in the next round, you'll be playing for $2,000. The second most popular, $1,500. And the third most popular, $1,000. You're not alone. You have your friends, the panelists here, to help you. You can choose three of them to give you a clue what they think, and then we'll go from there. So choose your first one.
Got to go with Andy.
Oh, Andy.
Oh, wow. I say rice.
Wild rice. Wild rice. All right, your second?
I'm going to go with Sean.
Sean.
Wild party.
Wild party. Right. Oh, audience likes it better. Tim, your third?
Pressure's on Deanne.
Deanne.
I was thinking berries.
Wild berries.
Oh, that's nice.
All right, so we have three quality answers. Wild rice, wild party, and wild berries. But it's up to you, Tim. You can take one of those, or you can go it on your own. What will it be?
Let me go with Wild Party.
Wild Party. All right.
Yeah,
for $1,000, we want to see Wild Party. Wild Boar.
Everyone's favorite.
That is...
The Wild Boar. Everybody loves it.
Tip of everyone's time.
Also, this survey took place in the medieval times. Right. For $1,500, we want to see Wild Party. Wild Party.
Yes.
Here we go. Just out of curiosity, the $2,000 answer was... Wild animal. So you made the good choice. Tim, now you're playing for $1,500 in the Star Whee! Wheel round.
Yeah. This
is our Star Wheel. Everyone's name is on it. When you spin it, whoever it lands on becomes your partner for the final clue. All right, okay. When I read it off, we need an exact match between you and your partner.
Okay.
Right now you're playing for $1,500 bucks, which is great. What would be nicer is if you land on one of the blinking red lights and it doubles to $3,000.
That would be nice.
That would be nice. All right. If you're ready, let's give her a spin.
All right.
That's all right. Yeah, that's okay. I just want you in a very particular place, Tim. All right.
Understood.
Tim, you'll say nothing while Deanne fills out this clue in silence. The clue is T blank. Oh. T blank.
What?
Deanne, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, Tim. The clue is T blank. What is your answer?
Bag.
T bag. The audience likes it. Let's see what we can do. Deanne, for $3,000, we're looking for tea bag.
Bag! Yeah! Yeah.